Hello friends, I'm Manisha Bora, Assistant Professor in Chemistry from BGS College. Today we are going to talk about addition-elimination reactions. Now what are these addition-elimination reactions? As the name indicates, addition means you're going to add some radical or some ion, and elimination means you're going to remove some molecule to get the product. So it's a combination of addition and elimination reaction. And therefore it is called as addition-elimination reaction. In that, we are going to see addition of ammonia derivatives. What is ammonia? So everyone knows that ammonia is NH3. And its derivatives means one of the hydrogen of ammonia is replaced by some other group. Let's say, in general, I am writing it as X. What are the different reagents possible? So, various reagents can be called as ammonia derivatives. For example, you have NH2OH. That is called as hydroxyl amine. Or, it is also called as hydroxyl amine hydrochloride. Is a molecule which is used to prepare oxime derivative from aldehydes and ketones. Then another molecule is hydrazine. So this particular molecule is hydrazine. And if you want to prepare a hydrazone derivative of aldehyde or ketone, this particular reagent is used. It is also available in the form of its salt, that is hydrazine hydrochloride. Then there is another molecule, that is NH2NHPH, that is called as phenyl hydrazine, or it also exists in its salt form, that is NH2NHPHHCl, that is phenyl hydrazine hydrochloride. Another molecule which can be written, that is NH2NH, and at alkaline composition you have nitro group, it is called as 2,4-dimethylphenylhydrazine as a reagent, and the product obtained will be called as hydrazone. We also have another molecule NH2, that is semiconductor. So all these reagents are all together, we will call them as ammonia derivatives. So what you can see, that we have X is OH, X is NH2, X is NHPH, X is NH and NO2, OxyOH. All these compounds, they form various types of derivatives with carbonyl compounds, that is with aldehydes or ketones. Now what we find, that all of these compounds, they contain nitrogen, and we know that nitrogen has two lone pairs of electrons. Nitrogen has one lone pair of electron on it, and therefore it is electron rich, which can undergo nucleophilic addition to carbonyl compounds. So let's see, when these compounds, these particular reagents, they react with aldehydes or ketones, what products you will get. So you now know different types of compounds which belong to this particular category, and now let's see how this reaction takes place. Any carbonyl compound you take, I've written R0R'. If R' is hydrogen, we call that as an aldehyde, or if it is alkyl group, then we call that as a ketone. So you can have either aldehyde or ketone taking part in this particular reaction. Now, when I react this with NH2X, we have nitrogen with a lone pair of electrons. Now, what this X can be? X can be OH, it can be NH2, The mechanism is same for all the reactions. Now what happens here, that first addition of this particular reagent takes place across carbonyl carbon. So step one over here is what? Addition. So this addition will take place. Now if you follow the arrows, what do you find? That you have RCO minus, single bond, NH, X, and this particular nitrogen has positive charge. Along with that, it also has R dash attached to this particular carbon. Obviously, this O minus will take this hydrogen and neutralize charge on this nitrogen atom. So if it happens, you will RCOH, single bond R, NH, X. This is what is obtained after addition. Now, this particular product form does not become stable here. It immediately undergoes elimination. Elimination of what? So, elimination of water molecules. See now here, you have here OH and H. So, this molecule undergoes elimination of water molecule, and which can be shown in this manner. H plus and OH minus, they together will form water molecule. So what is undergoing elimination? Water molecule is eliminated from this. And what product will get? R, C, R, double bond, N and X attached to this nitrogen. So this will be your product of this addition elimination reaction. And depending upon what reagent you have used, whether you have used hydroxyl, phenyl hydroxyl amine, whether you have used hydrazine or phenyl hydrazine, accordingly this product will have structure. This X will be attached to this N and remaining part of the molecule will be in this manner. So this is how we can show an addition elimination reaction for ammonia derivatives, and this is how it takes place in two steps. In the step one, it is undergoing addition, and in step 2, it is undergoing elimination to form the product. Most of the aldehydes and ketones, they become stable, and all these are called as derivatives. These are the derivatives of carbonyl compounds, which can be obtained by addition of these ammonia reagents. Thank you.